हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम हियर टू एक्सप्लेन माय प्रोजेक्ट स्मार्ट गॉगल्स फॉर ब्लाइंड एंड आई एम हैंडलिंग द पोर्शन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्शन। आई एम यूजिंग द वीजी 16 प्री ट्रेंड मॉडल अलॉन्ग विद द कोको डेटा सेट। वी हैव ट्रेंड ऑल आर ओन ऑब्जेक्ट लेयर्स ओवर द प्री ट्रेंड मॉडल। द इंक्लूडेड लाइब्रेरीज आर ओपन सी वी एंड टेंसर फ्लो। लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द कोड। वी हैव इम्प्लीमेंटेड द ऑब्जेक्ट डिटेक्शन लाइब्रेरी अलॉन्ग विद ओपन सी वी। Since the two libraries implement changes in separate scripts, we use the config library again. So, starting off, a class .NET is implemented. A class .NET is implemented. This class .NET implements the CNN sequential model with the frozen inference graph. The total number of labels are defined as defined using the text file label.pbtext, and the total number of classes are 90 with the threshold 0.6. We are capturing each frame one by one under an infinite loop. We have called a TensorFlow device and we are monitoring the progress. If the progress is along the learning curve, we are resizing each image and using the predict function to predict the image. Once this is done and we want to close the window, we are using the escape key to exit the loop and close the webcam. Also close all the windows. This is the file label.pb.txt that contains all the labels that can be used to detect images. This is defined by the COCO dataset itself. To implement the VGC16 model, we have imported TensorFlow along with the NumPy array and the COCO dataset with the VGC16. Now, we are loading and training images and reshaping them with the size of the models. We are calling the TensorFlow device and we are starting the session. Moreover, we are placing markers after each epoch so that we can monitor the progress along the learning curve. Implementing a feed forward neural network in batches. Again, we are calling the VG16 model and we are building or training images against the model with the image that is fed to it. Now, we have used the regression function along with the probability to determine the confidence of prediction. We are determining the confidence by matching it with the data set. This is the original dataset provided by the COCO and it contains all the object classifiers that can be detected with this model. By matching it with the original object dataset model, we can predict the probability as well as its confidence. The dataset in text format can be seen as this file. It contains a number of values and each value is returned corresponding to the object detected. Now to create the CNN model, we are again using the TensorFlow library. We are using a deep copy library. This is to create copies of the original objects. Since we are resizing and reshaping the images, we do not want it to be done on the original images. The changes are all done on the copy objects and the process is combined. The process is continued. Here we define the class net to create the sequential CNN with the total classifiers as 90 and minimum confidence of 60%. We then initialize the graph objects with none so that they are not influenced by the previous data collected from the earlier frames captured. Initializing the TF device, the TF is a TensorFlow device, we load all the graphs. We define the label functions that uses the net to map labels into categories. The categories can be segregated from each other by providing indexes to them. And the load graph function loads the inference graph in serialized or sequential form. The display function captures the height and width of the input image along with the height and width of the display image. The work is proceeded in the ratio to avoid discrepancies in different sizes of the objects captured in the dataset. Using the font Hershey Simplex, we capture the diagonal x and y coordinates by using the top left xy coordinate along with the height and width to get the bottom right coordinate. This is to mark the object inside the box. Now the predict function notes the starting and ending time of the frame, create copies, converts to gray and push them across the CNN model to get the scores. The score are the number of hits of an image. The final number of scores define the detection and classes. This is only when the 60% threshold criteria is satisfied. The final score is the label for the class. The original COCO dataset has objects in .txt directory that is returned by a particular value. This is the original dataset library that is called upon each label detection. Each label corresponds to a different number of objects, and each object can be called upon based on the detection. This is the final output that we will get on a particular detection. Now for the detection, it detects different objects in real time. Now as you can see the output,